tangent half-angle formula, a la Shmoop. Oh, what a catchy title. Vido the Mosquito is exhausted after returning from his business trip to Trigonometry Springs. Vido desperately needs an espresso. At Jolts and Volts Coffee, he orders his much-needed triple latte mocha frap. Vido has just returned from a business trip and realizes he has the wrong currency in his pocket as he reaches to pay his bill of tangent of pi over $8. He has only Trig Springs money. Oh dear. Here in his hometown of Half Angle Os, all money from the country of Trigonometry Springs is converted using the following formula. Tangent of u over 2 equals 1 minus the cosine of u over sine of u. How will Vito convert his money to the correct amount for his much-needed triple latte? First of all, we can see that the tangent of pi over 8 can be rewritten as 1 half times pi over 4. If we do this, we can get rid of the denominator 2 in our formula. Then if we substitute pi over 4 in for u, we get the following. 1 minus cosine of pi over 4 all divided by sine of pi over 4. Since cosine of pi over 4 equals the square root of 2 over 2, and the sine of pi over 4 equals the square root of 2 over 2, our formula becomes 1 minus the square root of 2 over 2 all over square root of 2 over 2. Having too many terms just brings trouble, so first, to simplify the numerator, we can put both terms under the same common denominator. Let's do this by multiplying 1 by 2 over 2 to get 2 over 2 minus root 2 over 2. We subtract fractions by subtracting across the numerator of the fractions and keeping the denominator the same. So we get 2 minus root 2 over 2 on the top of the bigger fraction. Got that? We hate fractions in the denominator with a passion, in fact. So let's multiply the numerator 2 minus root 2 over 2 by the reciprocal of the denominator to get rid of it. Yeah, just like that. The 2 in the numerator and denominator cancel out, so we're left with 2 minus root 2 divided by root 2. Piece of cake. We can't have radicals in the denominator, so we will rationalize it by multiplying the fraction by root 2 over root 2. This gives us the fraction root 2 times the quantity 2 minus root 2 all over 2. And to simplify, let's distribute the root 2 across the quantity 2 minus root 2 to get 2 root 2 minus 2 all divided by 2. Since we have a 2 on top and a 2 on the bottom, they cancel each other out. So our final quantity is root 2 minus 1. Fed up with having to go through so much math, Vito throws his money at the barista and demands his latte. The barista calmly reaches back and points to a sign saying, "We reserve the right to refuse service to anyone." Maybe try Starbucks across the street there, Vito. Oh well.